Today we are going to make a 3D scanner, which can scan any object and plot it in 3D space. Welcome to Robotics Everyday. This is a jar. I want its shape, appearance and dimensions for 3D printing. To do so, I could have measured its dimensions physically and made its CAD design. But that's too boring and me being lazy, so I built this scanner to get all the coordinates so that I can directly import them and print them. Its 3D plot looks like this. To 3D scan any object, we calculate its distance from top to bottom. For this, we are using an HCSR04 ultrasonic sensor attached to a servo motor. This gives us two dimensions. One is the horizontal distance between sensor and the point, and the second is the vertical distance of the point from ground. For the third dimension, the object needs to be rotated few degrees at a time and then scanned simultaneously. To do so, the object is placed on a gear and is rotated 18 degrees at a time by DC motor. To scan completely, the object is rotated and scanned 20 times. Thus we get the third dimension. Let's see its CAD design. This is the object, honeybee, that we are going to scan. To scan this honeybee, we have an ultrasonic sensor here. It is mounted on the horn of a servo motor so that it can be rotated. The honeybee is also mounted on a gear. The gear is driven by a worm connected to a DC motor. This arrangement reduces the speed of motor and provides precise rotation. For scanning, the ultrasonic sensor is rotated from top to bottom with the help of a servo motor. The sensor is sensing the distance between itself and the object in front of it simultaneously. After a scan, the object is rotated by a few degrees. Again, the sensor scans the distances from top to bottom. This process repeats until the object is rotated 360 degrees, and this is the real design. Here we can see an ultrasonic sensor connected to the servo motor and being rotated. To scan from top to bottom, the object to be scanned is placed on the gear. This gear is driven by a worm connected to a DC motor, and this mechanism rotates the object a few degrees after each top to bottom scan. But I replaced this motor with this new motor because of its poor performance. We will discuss the issue later. Let's see the trigonometry behind this scanner. Here we have the sensor pointing to the top of the bee. We want the height of that point and its horizontal distance. The sensor provides distance d, but that is a slanted distance. We want it in vertical or horizontal. We know the angle at which the sensor is being rotated by the servo motor. That's theta. So the horizontal distance will be d cosine of theta, and the vertical distance will be d sine of theta. We already know the height of the sensor from ground. That is h. So the total vertical distance will be h plus d sine of theta. When the sensor is rotated and is at 0 degrees, the cosine of 0 is 1. So the horizontal distance is equal to d. The sine of 0 is 0. So the vertical distance of the point will be equal to the height of the sensor from the ground, h. The sensor is again rotated. The math of horizontal distance remains the same. Just the vertical distance is reversed. Now the vertical distance becomes h minus d sine of theta. That's how we get the coordinates of the points from top to bottom. There is an issue with this worm gear mechanism. The worm is not engaged properly with gear, so the gear does not move. That's why we choose a new motor. This new motor is more precise and has smooth rotation without wobble. With every pulse of 120 milliseconds, the motor rotates 18 degrees. To plot the data collected, we used Python programming language. It has a library called MatplotLib. It can plot 3D. The MatplotLib plots in the Cartesian coordinate system, that is x.y.z. But we have scanned the object in the cylindrical coordinate system. So the plot of a cylinder looks like this from our scan. A plain wall of points scanned. So we have to do some calculations to convert them and make them look like this, a hollow cylinder. The result of the plot is not up to the mark. This is what a cylinder should look like. It should have the circular circumference and straight height. But this is how it looks in the real scan. The lines are not straight. The circumference is not circular. The top has some garbage values. This is what a ball should look like after a scan. Proper spherical. And this is how it looks in the real scan. The top and bottom parts are missing. From any angle, it doesn't look circular. I am not satisfied with the result. It requires many modifications, which we will do in the future. to get a good scan of the objects. That's all for now. See you again with more robotic technologies. Robotics every day.